There's been a lot of construction going on at home, and I guess I just forgot that my boots were located beside the entrance or near the doorway. They're just on an open shelf, so I don't know, it didn't really occur to me that they were gonna get dirty. The construction's been going on for around 2 weeks, and I just noticed that my boots have become really, really, really dusty. So you can see how thick this layer is. It's way thicker in real life. It's more noticeable on the shiny leathers. So I really need to clean these up. If I don't, they might be harder to remove, so it's best to do that now. I tend to clean my boots and my leather things, the recorder. I really do use them all for shooting especially, so I make sure I take care of them to prolong their life. But of course Doc Martens will last you forever, but they still need some TLC. I normally just use leather cleaner, but today I think I'm actually gonna have to vacuum these. The dust is really thick, so I'm gonna vacuum them first, I think, and then wipe them with a dry towel, and then a damp towel, and then proceed with my usual cleaning, which is just using furniture polish, and I also have Doc Martens balm, so I'll show you that in a bit. Because I have a lot of shoes and boots that are leather, I have a trusty cleaning kit. Oh dear, these are so dirty. You can see the dirt more from here. So, inside my kit are a couple of things, starting with a suede brush. I don't really have a lot of suede shoes, and I don't tend to buy suede shoes just because I'm always on the ground and I don't want them getting dirty, but I do have this just in case. I have goo gone, so for anything that's stuck on the soles, this is pretty good at removing those, especially stickers. I have a normal Kiwi Shine and Protect, and this is neutral, so I use these on my colored boots, like my red ones or my blue ones. And then of course I have a toothbrush to get into those ridges, especially for Doc Martens, they will always have ridges. I have an eraser. This also lifts the dirt. I have these touch-up markers. They're actually for furniture, but sometimes if you have scuffed heels, especially the stacked wooden heels, these are okay at covering those up. I have a used foam from my last cleanup. These are actually just from shoulder pads. And then I have wet tissues. And lots of shoulder pads, because I buy a lot of blouses that have shoulder pads. I cut them up and then I save them to use for cleaning shoes. I have a sock. So if you have socks that are missing their pair, you can use those to clean your shoes or stuff them, especially if you want to make your shoes a bit bigger. I stuff these into the toe boxes. And then I just have regular furniture polish. Emerald for my black shoes. Make sure you don't get them on the soles. They're very slippery, so I just use them on the main part of the shoe. And then I just have leather cleaner. I'm not particular with the brand. And this one I just got from Japan Home. And then, what else do I have here? Yeah, just more shoulder pads, more socks, a scissor if I need to trim any laces, brown and black shoe polish, and the Doc Martens Wonder Bomb.